Hello everybody, my name is Geronimo Z and welcome to this brand new series that I'm trying out. Welcome to Yugioh WTF Moments. Now I know what you're thinking, isn't this just a copy of Cultaholic? And no, I have no idea who they are and I've never watched one of their videos. This is actually heavily inspired by Ace Trainer Liam's WTF Moments. And his is a copy of Cultaholic, so mine's a copy of a copy. For anyone who has no idea what's going on, I'll be taking a look at the Yu-Gi-Oh! Anime, the original one, and I'll just be ripping it apart, pulling it, making fun of it, just all for chits and giggles. This is not serious. Please don't get upset. I love the original show. I've got big nostalgia goggles for it, but doesn't mean we can't just take a look back and poke a little fun at it, eh? I'm going with the 4Kids version because it's an easy punching bag, because the dialogue's funnier, the edits are goofier, and there'll be other weird little things that we can point out because of how 4Kids ran things, I suppose. With that out of the way, let's get down to business. Before we start ripping into the show, I do want to point out that no matter what you've got to say about 4Kids, they sure know how to make some banging OPs. So the episode starts out with Joey and Yugi having a duel, but if you look at the cards in Joey's hands, the one on the far left and the one on the far right don't exist. Don't know where he got his cards from, but he's clearly being scammed. In this shot we have the 4Kids cards, but in this shot we have the original cards. If you're gonna change shit, 4Kids, at least be consistent. Joey here seems to have 5 face down cards, but one of them is blue, one of them is purple, and one of them is green. Where the fuck is he getting these cards? Half of them seem to be fake and non-playable. Question, why are the bows on the girl's uniform so fucking big? Also, Jesus Christ, Tia's chin could cut a melon. While Joey and Yugi are dueling, we see Seto Kaiba just chilling in the corner. We later find out that Kaiba is the CEO and majority shareholder of his own multinational billion-dollar games company, and he is also an egotistical prick who thinks he's better than everyone. So why is he at a public school? Surely he'd be homeschooled or in some sort of snobbish private school, you know, not sat here with the rest of these dweebs. Yugi and friends are having a conversation about Yugi's grandpa, who owns the game shop. Kaiba overhears this conversation and says to himself,
"Rare card? Could they have found the card I've been searching for?"
Mate, there's hundreds of rare cards. I highly doubt some old man in a game shop has the exact one you're looking for. Granted, it turns out he does have the card he's looking for, but my point still stands. Yugi and friends arrive at Grandpa's game shop, and Grandpa decides to show them this super rare card. Why the fuck is it so big? Is it a YCS promo card or something? Look at this card in my hand. Look at the card to hand ratio, then look at Grandpa. Then look at Grandpa. That is ridiculously big. Direct quote from Grandpa.
"This card is priceless. There are only 4 of them in all the world."
I call bullshit. There's no way that a children's card game that's become such a widespread phenomenon that the creator of said game can host some big tournament on a mystery island with hundreds of participants for him to only have printed 4 of one card. That seems a little bit far-fetched. I can go on eBay right now and get a Blue Eyes for about 4 quid. Grandpa is lying out of his fucking ass. So at this point, Kaiba's strolled in to come take a look at the Blue Eyes, and he offers Grandpa a massive suitcase full of cards as a trade. Now that seems like a good idea at first, until you take a closer look. Firstly, the spiky green lizard thing, not real, and the rest of these aren't worth jack shit. There's a fusion monster in there with less attack and defense points than the Blue Eyes in question. What is even the point of that fusion monster? Kaiba is a scamming bastard. Pass it on. For some reason in this shot, Joey's teeth are British.
Hey, look, they're basically the same.
Kaiba then offers to pay literally any amount of money for this one card, and Grandpa still says no. All because a dear friend gave it to him. Mate, I'm pretty sure this dear friend would not care if you decided to get £10 million for this one card and then split it halfway with said friend. If I was that friend, I'd call him a fucking moron for giving up that deal. Kaiba's willing to pay anything and he's a millionaire. Come on, mate, use your fucking brain. I jotted down a note here for this scene that says dramatic zoom, no Death Note joke. I have no idea what that means or what my point was supposed to be, so if you happen to know, answers on a postcard. Kaiba then proceeds to call Grandpa a senile old fool. Yeah, he's right, Grandpa's a fucking nutter. So, the next day, what appears to be debt collectors have appeared to come and take Grandpa to Kaiba for a duel. And oh look, it's Humpty Dumpty. Direct quote from Grandpa.
Young Kaiba doesn't understand, but I'll teach him a lesson about the heart of the cards.
Mate, why do you care? He's just some snobby rich kid. Stop entertaining this fucker and get on with your day. Yugi and friends later arrive at the game shop, and the silly old fool has left the door unlocked. I'm surprised the shop hasn't been ransacked yet. He wasn't kidnapped. He went willingly. At least according to the dub, he had time to at least lock up. The shop phone then rings, and it just happens to be Kaiba, which is convenient that he was able to ring at just the right time when Yugi and friends arrive. But whatever, plot conveniences will be plot conveniences, I guess. Kaiba lets Yugi know that he needs to come pick up his grandpa, because he's not feeling very well. And Yugi responds with,
Kaiba, what have you done, Kaiba?
It's kind of rude to assume Kaiba did anything. At least he was courtesy enough to give you a call that he needs help. He could have just, you know, left the old man on the floor. So Yugi and friends arrive at Kaiba World? I don't think they ever specified. So we see Grandpa on the floor, basically dying, and he is like that because he lost at a children's card game. How does someone get in that state from just playing a card game? Can someone please tell me? So Kaiba explains that they had a duel, and the prize was each player's most valuable card. And that just makes Grandpa a hypocrite. He said earlier he would never ever give that up in any circumstance. So why would he agree to the terms of that duel? If you really valued that card that much, even if he was 100% confident that you would win, you would not put that card up as a prize. Direct quote from Tia.
Kaiba, you should be ashamed of yourself.
For what? Playing a children's card game with an old man. Kaiba technically hasn't done anything wrong here. At this point, I'm pretty sure Grandpa put himself on the floor to get sympathy, like they do in football all the time. Kaiba shows off his newly acquired blue eyes and then proceeds to rip it in half. Why would you rip it? You went through all this trouble just to get the card and then you rip it. You could have kept it somewhere. You could have put it in your extra deck or in another duel or something. You could have done anything with it, but you choose to rip it. Does nobody in this show have a brain? Kaiba then says,
Blue Eyes is a rare and powerful card, and this one will never be used against me.
Mate, it was owned by some old man that runs a shop, who never planned on giving it away or using it in the first place. It was never going to be used against you. Kaiba is a fucking moron. Gramps hands Yugi his deck and says,
I taught you everything I know, Yugi.
And if that's the case, and everything Yugi knows is what you taught him, how'd you expect him to win against Kaiba when you failed miserably to do so? Joey then says to Yugi,
we can look after your grandpa while you take care of creepy Kaiba.
Why are you telling him to prioritize a children's card game instead of his injured grandpa? That doesn't sound very protagonist-y. Here's a direct quote from Joey.
You're like the best player I've ever seen. You've got the Manellian puzzle. You can do this, Yugi.
Firstly, I'd like to apologize for the butchering of a Brooklyn accent. I can't do an accent to save my life. Secondly, how does the puzzle help, Joey? It's just a fucking necklace. You've not exactly seen it in action, have you? Tia starts giving a big old speech about friendship whilst there's an old man seriously injured on the floor. Y'all need to move your asses right now and get this man to hospital instead of wasting time drawing on your fucking hands. It's just really funny to me that they had to call an ambulance because an old man lost at a children's card game. Do you see how ridiculous that sounds when you say it out loud? Tia convinces Joey to stay behind to cheer Yugi on. How in the world is that useful? Why do they care so much about this duel? No matter how many times I see it, this transformation animation always hypes me up. What? No one said all the WTF moments had to be negative. I do have a question though. Why is he shouting his own name? It's also taken until this transformation to notice that Yugi has a belt around his neck. Yugi is into stuff? Pass it on? Kaiba reacts to this transformation with a what the? And then proceeds to continue on with the duel. Are you seriously not going to question the fact that your opponent has grown by several feet, their clothes have changed, their voice has got deeper, all within the blink of an eye? No? Okay then. Kaiba then explains that this arena produces lifelike holograms of all the cards. Yugi then proceeds to go, so this is how you beat my grandpa. No Yugi, your grandpa just sucks at the game. Kaiba summons a monster and we then get this direct quote from Hitsumi Giant. After being attacked, Kaiba makes noises like, ah! Why is he making noises as if he's been hurt? They're just holograms. Is everyone in this anime a fucking drama queen? Also, Mokuba is here for some reason. Fuck off, Mokuba. Direct quote from Yugi.
Huh, a magic card.
No, it's a spell card.
Actually, back then they used to be called magic cards, but they changed the name to avoid legal troubles with Magic the Gathering.
That's cool, but I don't remember asking. A little bit later on in the duel, and Kaiba then plays this card, which is not a real card. Kaiba is a cheater. Confirmed. Yugi puts Sangang, this fucking monster, face down, and Kaiba destroys it. But then Yugi doesn't use its effect.
This scene is actually the beginning of a montage. He could have activated it, we just didn't get to see it.
Yeah, well, shut up. This montage, if we can really call it that, because it only contains two more monsters being destroyed, contains a really weird laugh from Kaiba and a really weird grunt from Yugi. It sounds like Yugi is straining for a shit. Ugh! Kaiba starts to taunt Yugi about his grandpa losing, and Yugi says he's a better duelist than you'll ever be. No, he isn't. If he was a better duelist, he would have won. Just because you don't like Kaiba doesn't make him a bad duelist. A shitty person for sure, but a bad duelist? No. Yugi then goes on to talk highly of his grandpa and says shit like, I can feel his heart in this deck. You're just chatting bollocks at this point, mate. Just shut the fuck up and get on with the duel. Your grandpa's at hospital waiting for you. Yugi then goes on to state, I doubt you have that kind of faith in your cards, Kaiba. Yes he does. That's why he's a super cocky, annoying piece of shit. Because he's confident in his deck and has faith in his cards. Stop chatting bollocks and actually think before you speak. Yugi then summons Guy the Fierce Knight with no tributes. That card requires two monsters to be sacrificed. Summons without the right amount of tributes happens a lot in this series, especially season 1, so I'm only going to mention it this once. Otherwise, it's just going to be me padding out the runtime with piss irritating repetition. Speaking of piss irritating repetition, don't forget to like this video if you've been enjoying it, subscribe to the channel if you want me to make more of these, hit the notification bell because that's important for some reason, and leave a lovely comment down below. It can be something generic if you like, it could be pee pee poo poo for all I care, just comment something. Let's see if we can get this video to, I don't know, 50 likes? That's something. That'll be enough to tell me that this series is worth continuing. I'll probably still continue it anyway, but it will motivate me to get it done faster. Wink, wink. Did I really just say wink, wink? Oh. Kaiba summons a blue-eyes white dragon, and smart-ass Joey over here says,
Impossible! We all watched Kaiba tear that card in half!
It's a children's card game, Joey. More than one version of that card will exist. Thousands of them, probably. Kaiba then goes on a rant about how you win with power and not faith. I'm with Kaiba on this one. He's kind of got a point. Sure, there is some luck involved, and this anime does love pushing the whole heart of the cards bullshit, but in all seriousness, if your opponent has a really powerful deck and you don't have anything to counter it, you're fucked, mate. No amount of faith in the heart of the cards is gonna save your ass. We now cut to the hospital where Grandpa is, and he says,
Don't give up, Yugi!
Why do you fucking care? You're literally dying! While Yugi is thinking about his strategy, Grandpa appears as a ghost and starts coaching him. So I guess this man just fucking died, and the first thing he does in the afterlife is go to Yugi to help him win this children's card game. Why does nobody in this show have their priorities straight? After Grandpa is done giving his advice, he then seems to be dragged back? Grandpa is sulking, confirmed. In this flashback, we can hear Grandpa talking, but his lips aren't moving. In this flashback, Grandpa claims that nobody has ever been able to summon Yugioh. And I mean, technically, he's kind of right. You don't summon Yugioh. Having all five cards in your hand is an instant win condition. You don't actually summon anything. Back to the duel, Yugi then activates Swords of Revealing Light, stopping Kaiba's monsters attacking for 3 turns. Kaiba, in response to that, summons another monster, claiming that this monster is not affected by that spell card. Is that so? Let me just check my... Just as I thought. Kaiba is chatting bollocks. Kaiba's a dirty little cheater. Confirmed. Again, we then get this direct quote from Yugi.
The deck, it sensed my doubt.
The fuck are you on about?
They're just cards.
After all that bollocks about the heart of the cards, his friends all then appear as ghosts. Did they all die too? What the fuck happened at that hospital? So by some miracle, Yugi managed to acquire all 5 pieces of Exodia. And he puts them on the board, which you're not really supposed to do, but hey ho. But he's put them down in the wrong order. So the left leg and arm are to the right of the head, and the right leg and arm is to the left of the head. What's that all about? It just looks stupid. What the fuck happened to Kaiba? Simply seeing a hologram of Exodia has made all his blood run dry from his body like he's been sucked by a vampire. Here, you can see the life points go down. Exodia is a win condition. It doesn't affect the life points. Direct quote from Mokuba.
This can't be. My brother never loses.
Well, he just did. So shut the fuck up, Mokuba. Kaiba, still in shock about the defeat, says,
but how could I lose to him?
Because he had Exodia. Duh. Did you not see the giant fuck off hologram? Yugi then adds insult to injury and decides to mind crush Kaiba. According to the manga, that puts his enemies into a coma. What the fuck, dude? That's not very protagonist-y. We cut back to Grandpa, once again, on his deathbed, and he wakes up and says,
Yugi won!
How the fuck do you know that? I'm convinced his soul did actually leave his body, and he sort of just lingered around the duel until it was over and then came straight back. So we're at the end of the episode, and this dude informs Pegasus that Kaiba lost in the duel. But how does he know that? I highly doubt that Kaiba would be the sort of person to come forward and admit that he's been defeated by someone. Oh god, I bet it was Mokuba. Fucking little rat. You better watch his back, because snitches get stitches. Fuck you, Mokuba.